Hello, welcome to Dimension Quest. Today's video is part of my Ubuntu 22.04 Jammy Jellyfish How to Install series, where I step through one of the tools I use or provide in the Ubuntu desktops I provide for my team. Today's video will be on Visual Studio Code. This is a must-have code editor and a favorite of many. There's a few different ways to install Visual Studio Code on Ubuntu 22.04. Let's go over each one. First, there's the Ubuntu Store. Then there's the browser download and install, and there's a scripted install. Let's take a look at the Ubuntu Store. All right, once that comes up, you can just click in the top left corner on the magnifying glass there and search for Visual Studio. And you will quickly see that we have the Visual Studio Code here on the first one. Now that second one, Code Insiders, that's still Visual Studio Code, but this is more of a daily build where you have the bleeding edge version of the editor. I like to just stick with the stable version here. Now you can take a look at a little bit of the information about Visual Studio Code here, and you can click Install. So this is going to install from the Snap Store. Click Install. And that's it. So now if we click on our applications, we can see that we have Visual Studio Code installed. All right, so that's the first way of installing VS Code. Let's take a look at another way. Let's go ahead and delete this for now. I'll uninstall. Okay, we'll close out of the Ubuntu Store. Next up, we'll take a look at how we can do it from the browser. From the browser, you'll want to open whatever your favorite browser is and go to code.visualstudio.com. Once the browser loads, it'll see whether you're running Windows, Mac, or Linux. If you're running Linux, it'll give you a choice between the Debian packages or the RPM packages, or you could just click the download link in the top right corner where you'll be presented with all the different options to download. Now, since I'm running Ubuntu 64-bit, I'll select the Debian 64-bit package right here. Now it should automatically start downloading. It's already done. So we can go into that folder, right click on the file, and select Open with Other Application. Now you'll want to select Software Install. Click Select, and that'll load up the Ubuntu software. Once this page loads up, just click Install. Now we can see here in the top right corner, it's installing from a local file, Debian package. Once this gets installed, that Debian package is actually going to provide your operating system with the apt repository. So in the future, you can do a sudo apt upgrade and get your Visual Studio Code upgrades. I didn't mention earlier, but when you install via the Snap Store, the snaps will be updated as well. Okay, installation is complete. Let's check our applications. And there it is, Visual Studio Code. Okay, so those are the two easy ways that most people are likely going to use. Now, there is another way, and this is for the more advanced people that typically want to do a scripted install. Now, if you want to do a scripted install, go to the left-hand side here under Setup and select Linux. Here we can see we have installation guide. If you scroll down a little bit, we can see that if we had downloaded that Debian file and wanted to do the installation via the command line, we could simply issue one of these two commands here. And as I noted earlier, installing the deb package will automatically install the apt repository and the signing key to enable auto-updating using the system's package manager. Now, if we wanted to incorporate the installation of Visual Studio Code into a script, we could simply use this code snippet here. Once this has been run, we update our apt repository and then we can do a sudo apt install code. Now before we go and install apt code, I'm going to clean up the current installation. So let's go take a look here. Sudo apt remove code. Yes. Okay, so now if I type code, we'll see that we no longer have Visual Studio Code installed. Let's check our apt repositories and make sure that we have that cleared up as well. Okay, VS Code list file is no longer there, but we'll need to update our apt repository so that our operating system knows that VS Code is no longer available. And we can see that we only have these four repositories listed. So now let's go ahead and issue the commands from the script here. We'll just copy that. And I'm already logged in as root. I did a sudo space su space dash earlier. So I can just paste in these commands and hit enter. Okay, so we've already got wget. That's one of the things that it wanted to do there. Now that we have all of that done, we can issue these commands here. So let's go ahead and do that. And we can see now that our repository list includes Visual Studio Code here, as well as a few other things. We should now be able to do a sudo apt install. I'm going to do a dash y so that I don't have to do confirmation. Press enter. And if we do which code, that'll tell us that we do have code installed and it's in user bin code. And if we click on our applications down here, we should be able to see Visual Studio Code installed again. And there we go. We've got it installed three different ways in just a few minutes. So if you happen to notice it earlier, when I'm logged in with my regular profile here, I do have my Oh-My-ZSH prompt here because I am using the ZSH shell and I like having the extra utility that that framework gives me. But on a clean install, if you open the terminal in VS Code, we have a bit of a problem here. Look at that. All of the Unicode icons are not showing, and that's because we don't have Visual Studio Code using the correct font. Let's go ahead and fix that right now. If we go into File, Preferences, Settings, we should be able to adjust the font here. Okay, Font Family. Now, the font that I'm using is called Meslo LGS NF. Okay, once we have our entry in there, we should be able to just close out of the file there and then save it. And look at that, it's already fixed. Okay, so we have covered three different ways of installing Visual Studio Code in Ubuntu 22.04 Jammy Jellyfish, and we even did a little bonus content of fixing the prompt in the terminal for Oh-My-ZSH in Visual Studio Code. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this how-to video on installing Visual Studio Code with Ubuntu 22.04. If you haven't done it yet, please make sure you hit like and subscribe. I'll have a number of other videos coming up here real soon. Thanks. Have a great day. Mm-hmm.